Hello everyone, my name is Raman. Today in this video I want to talk about what Mongolian tactic is and how it can be used and how grandmasters use it. So in this current position, let's assume that it is white to move. So the white just played the move, let's suppose white just played the move b5, and now we can see that there is a tension between two pawns. So instead of resolving the tension or just supporting the pawns with some other pieces, like placing a knight or giving some support with other pieces, instead of doing all those things, resolving or supporting the tension, so what we do is we create more tension by bringing more pieces into tension. This is called Mongolian tactic. So obviously in this position black can just simply take the pawn, but I just want to illustrate what actually Mongolian tactic is. So when there is a tension between two pawns, instead of resolving or supporting with other pieces, what we do is we just bring one more piece. If there is a knight somewhere, like maybe somewhere on d7, instead of supporting by bringing back to a knight to b8 to support this pawn or just taking the pawn, what we do is we create more tension. So if white takes, and we can either push or we can take, and what actually Mongolian tactic does is it either creates a passed pawn or it completely destroys the our opponent's pawn structure. So let's look at this in an example. So for clear understanding. So this is a game between Magnus, Carlsen and Wang Yue, played in the year 2010. So in the, here Magnus Carlsen is white and Wang Yue is black, and so here black to move, black just played the move g5. So here instead of either resolving or doing something, Magnus Carlsen played the move g4. So what he does is already there is a tension between two pawns, h4 and g5, and instead of resolving it or playing something like king e3, what he does is he pushes his g3 pawn to g4, so creating more tension. So now all the four pawns are in now there is more tension than what it used to be in the previous move. So if Wang Yue just played the move h takes g4. So what happens if g takes h4? We can take this pawn, we can take the hy pawn, and then there will be a two passes, but Magnus Carlsen passer will be more powerful than his, and because this passer can be stopped. So let's look at what happened. Obviously he cannot take this pawn because white can take on h5, and his passer will be a very good passer compared to his opponent's. So he took on g4, and Magnus Carlsen, if he takes the pawn structure will be destroyed completely. There will be two isolated pawns and double pawns. So white can try that, but here it is of no use. Instead he can obtain a clear passer. So after bishop e4, let's look at the game, what happened in the rest of the game. I will give you explanation here. Obviously if he takes, and he will get with a check, so he'll promote to queen with a check. So obviously he played the move king e3, and Wang Yue here resigned here because soon mate will follow with queen e8 check, and soon the mate will follow even though there is a queen, but still the mate is unavoidable. Actually it's a mate in 11 if you want to try it. So this is what Mongolian tactic is. If there is a tension between two pawns, bring the third pawn and let the other pawn join the party. Now there is more tension than what it used to be in the previous one. So I really like this Mongolian tactic. I even used it in my recent some of my games. So Yeah, this is these are some kind of important tactics which you need to which you need to understand and first, and then you have to implement in your own games to, you know, to obtain the results. So I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you for watching.